Hey, hello. Awali ku YouTube mwevali kuwa ngakwe muli. Let me hope wa subscribing. Today, this is Lynda. Inspire. Echa na chelingi sange nyana. Otegedi. So, chuzo kwa ugele huku bintu imu, bibini, bisatu, bina, awasinga mwuguza banange Lynda. Either boyfriend, aina, alimu, a dating, alimu relationship. Tu waga atumanyi, Lynda alibichi.
Halia, wanzi ndivu yangi.
Only a dance party.
We had dance party. Okay, yes, of course, I like the whole idea of a personal life, but somehow, somewhere, my work life took over. Well, yes, but me, it's now the good thing is, okudigida is part of my work.
True.
So, if I'm making.
Can you imagine?
Can you imagine? Okunyumira.
Wow. Nayatenga loza chalwa dela better omutnosoka no digida manyi kati bomalo okufumbirwa for example kati nganze eno jendi sasa wakwela party animal
yes
blaba because wali responsibilities abana mwami nebya la binje vigenda vyegata ko so it's better you party first then you settle
down leo just over okuchakala ngoli no musacha
ai walo bintu sobola kola kati hugs zofuna zenyizo butasola zikiriza
baba manyi it wouldn't be a problem if he has known me from the beginning. That's the problem. The problem that usually happens is you introduce your man to a life that is not yours. That
true.
Is usually the problem that happens. So you pretend that you're not about this, yet that's actually what you're about.
Okay.
If you show him exactly who you are, he gets used to who you are. If he knows your work environment, who you work with, as long as you're open enough to let him in, I don't think there would be a problem.
Lynda, sometimes I'm sad about you.
Oh, that's true.
Yes.
Yeah, I've been there.
Oh, she again. So, I'm going to tell you, Kafi, with a dance party.
Not okay, she said, I'm
not going to
gamba. But what if? What if?
You know? What if? Oh, funyo luvuto. Oh, gonna come dance party is ezo. What if you have a kid?
What if? Would you mind doing anything aside from that?
Oh, she said, I'm going to choose. For example, cutting up going over followers, let me say, go Twitter.
Yes.
Mtakuwanya kusudewe bina gama nono sicha ya gala. Lynda wabugoe boya mba sicha wakala blala.
Exactly.
Kuchuchu same way bintu. Ochawa. Nothing in the beginning he was like, oh, I'm okay. I'm very okay with that.
Yes.
Get a mask on nature chokula. Sometimes I'm dropping and I'm dropping.
Yes.
Karengo kufuna excuses. Toja genda. Ndi muragde. Dede. Ochita gira.
Yes.
Nego olowoza anti omuntu. Yabade hagala omuntu gwakola na yomulimu gwe nyini. Over outside.
Nze.
Like wadolo waza. That for example you. Wale wado ya galango mtu gwakola na yomu dance party so that oba DJ, oba producer.
Right now the fact is also that you cannot pick and choose who you end up falling for. Yinzo kusangaga. Na inga mbaa saga umudu wa
that is nyo,
that's doing exactly what I'm doing.
Why?
Maybe if he's a DJ because he would be not exactly, we're not exactly the same.
Okay.
At least we are ukana mukatini. But imagine, the presenter and the
presenter. Same set all the time.
Same set.
24/7, that is home
that,
and work.
That may not, because nga wobinaba, we're tukolea abantu bogela.
I know.
This guy. And then this other person, you have to think about them. They'll be subject to all
true.
The things that actually happen. So even if at first we both understand it, it will still be stressful to the relationship. So not exactly the same thing. Though I personally wouldn't want someone that is doing what I'm doing.
Do you think also kusobola omusajja ali so possessive?
Possessive.
Gaine buba.
Na mera ko no musajja ali possessive. So I know what it's like. And the problem is not even a problem. Okay, yeah, it was a problem, but it's abusive new. So in the process I ended up losing who I was or forgetting who I am and what I like or what it is that I would rather be. And it took me a while to realize I'm also a person in the relationship. So it's not all about that other person. You also have to be able to ngamusobola kubera nga mwembi
muri ku same page.
Yeah, in the relationship.
So how long did you take you okutegera ntikati oli mu abusive kanchogere wenge relationship?
It was a while, like 3 years or slightly more than that. Ngabantu bangamba naye ngasiburira okutegera. Like ne bangamba ngandoza just buzzala wa something like that. They don't want to see me happy, they don't want to see me prevail. And then afterwards otuke chiranga nebyo yaga kogera ngatoso yabyokera. That's when you realize, but I'm also part of the relationship. Why can't I say what I don't like? Why can't I say what you get?
It's 50-50.
Then you realize at some point when you're not with him, because you've lost all your friends in the process and that kind of thing. But then it's not something you realize on your own.
Mm.
It takes a little while after so many people telling you. Well, you're calling it there because usually.
Make it watch Zudi, Ochkolo, TH in Tungecho. You know, Ola World, you come up for your Montuyeka.
I took it saying that you could too
soon.
It's not that you've fallen out of love with a person, I ain't just too soon, Kubera.
Like that. Yes, exactly. Directing at your
so it's at that point, Ochiburi, at some point, usually. Like what makes us stay is the fear of what will happen
people
after.
People will say. What people
not
will
even
say.
What people will say of if I leave him and then who will I find? Am I going to begin again? Then you end up just trying to stay and stay. Now you took it and got tosovura, like never collaging or gamba. At the end of the day, right now, I cannot cry anymore. I cannot be this angry because. You become those bitter people that are always angry.
Usungu.
Exactly.
Yet.
And yet no one is supposed to be like
unyiga.
That. Exactly.
I get it.
No, you yourself, you'll notice that you've changed. You're not the person that you were before.
True.
When you realize that even the friends that you felt were the truest and the realest are not are not part of your life anymore, that's when it starts to hit you that, what happened? What happened? Then you have to be strong enough to say, you know what, I'm done. You may not be out of love with this person. Usually at the end of the day, you can't just fall out of love.
True.
But you can get tired. You're human. So when you feel like you've reached the breaking point, it's okay to say I'm done. Just
you can tell your partner that I'm done.
You say you're done. You're done. And you actually let them know. If you've fallen out of love with them, then you tell them the reason is I've fallen out of love with you. But when you're done, you're just done. You don't even have to give an excuse. Yes, I'm done.
If you still love
the person, but I love you, but I can't. I cannot be part of this relationship if I'm not
free
happy,
to do what? Yeah, okay.
If I'm not feeling like myself, if I'm feeling like I do not have a voice, you're just done. That is what you're done with.
Oh.
If that person is willing to change at that point, maybe you can go on. But usually it's just something people say to keep you. Usually, so it's up to you when you feel like you really can't. You have to be brave enough to walk away. But it's not easy.
Not easy.
At all.
Hey man, kato wapo your relationship wedyo. Na inga to muntu wabado mwagala nyo.
Etwale obude.
Obena kolo oti.
Buli moto kajola wabolo waza yeye.
Esimu not shaking akome vuga.
Nesimu nola wanda waba agenda kukubira. Never kukubira, you still think about should I pick, should I not pick. Because it takes a while for you to learn to be yourself. But then now, at that point, you have to first now learn to love you. Usually people forget that you weren't loving yourself. So you have to now put yourself back in the equation.
If there's something
you want to get it. Do not think about those things of, if I eat too much ice cream, I'll grow fat. Eat the ice cream.
Spoil yourself.
Eat the ice cream. Do it until you feel like, okay, now, let me begin again. You'll reach a point in which you're like, okay, now I've enjoyed too much. I can now hit restart. But usually that restart doesn't come because I can say for a fact, when I had to teach myself how to learn myself, how to love myself, I only got to realize after a while that I was the only one that was just, I would be at a party and everyone is holding hands and doing this. And then I'm standing there, I'm like, and then after 2 seconds, I'm like, exactly. And then that's now usually the problem. Getting back to see now another life, because originally I was the fairy tale kind of person. I believe the person you meet at first, like that's going to be the father of your kids.
I know, right?
You have that plan in your head, the way we remembered it in primary and all those things.
I know.
Life, though. Life can teach you a lesson. This is all what the whole
but,
idea.
But it's good. Okuchimanya, na kubera nyonyonyo, you know, attached.
Yes. But sometimes you find yourself very attached. Haven't you ever been in a relationship and your friends are his friends? His family is basically now your family. That is how intertwined you are.
They're all in the circle.
Exactly.
I know.
So the problem is now after that. That's why people stay in the relationship. They're like, after that, what is going to happen.
No friends. Yes. Yeah.
Or these ones are going to see me wrong for leaving, or this. And that's usually the fear for the most cases, the ladies, because they keep projecting the failure of the relationship to the lady not trying. Whether or not they have offended us, apparently we're supposed to forgive and forgive and forgive and forgive,
until when you get tired.
Exactly. Yes. And yet, even if you're to try to explain that you've done so, but things just weren't working, they still think traditionally in the African setting, you're supposed to be able to make your relationship work. So when you feel that fear of being the failure in all women is what usually keeps people there.
I know. But parents, whatever mind, like your parents or your friends,
yes,
your sisters or your brothers,
that's the
boyfriend.
You're looking for, at first you'd be like, he's okay for like a while, and then you're like, huh. Like when you realize that they're also not stupid, they can realize you're not around
in your life.
Yes, and then you just try to avoid the conversation. Usually some people will still ask, obviously, like aunties or whatever, but you have to get through it somehow. To get through it. The only problem is people rush now to replace a person that they were in with, and I don't think that's a good idea, because
is that love really?
It's not really. You're going to project all the anger or whatever it is you had from the previous relationship to the next person. That's why I would advise, give yourself time, get over it, so that if you're to get into a new relationship, you're not still thinking that a relationship is what you came from. You're giving this other relationship a new chance, a fresh, because haven't you ever seen girls who will always assume their man is cheating just because the one they were with before was a cheat.
Yeah,
this other one is genuinely not, but you keep thinking that is what it is, because you're not yet over it.
True.
That's the thing. So you give yourself time. That's like, just learn who you are, what you like, what you don't like, so that you can be able to show what you like and what you don't like for the next one.
So true. Yeah. So do you think NTV dance party yet damage for Choli, like it's trying to fill the gap?
Actually, even the beat, anyway, I throw myself into work to make myself, I don't know how I can, it's like a distraction.
Yeah.
But then at some point, that's how it started out, a distraction for me to be able to re-see myself or like build myself, build my confidence, build my everything. That was the initial. And then
discover who you are.
Exactly. Mm. And I felt like I had gotten into this place where I actually love who I am. I can be who I am really openly with no answering to who.
I know. Where are you? Why are you late?
Even if it wasn't where are you, like, why did you?
Yeah.
I can do what I want. Now, that's the beauty about if you are in a relationship with someone who already knows what you are.
You do, yeah.
What you do.
Yes.
What kind of person you actually are. Because everyone knows I'm jolly, but at the end of the day, I mind my business. I love all the time. I'm basically, I think, the most social person that I can think of. So imagine if I get a man who doesn't understand that is who I am.
Exactly.
Because I'll greet people, I'll talk to people, and he has to be able to be comfortable, not just in me, but in himself.
Exactly.
So my ideal man, the man I want to marry, would have to be confident in himself.
True.
To know that even if she talks to who and who, I am the man.
I'm the main guy.
Yes, now that is the kind of man that would work on my end. So that I don't have to over-explain to him that, baby,
you're the one.
Yes.
Hey, guys, my boyfriend. Hello.
Yes, exactly.
My boyfriend. Kuganga, you're totally comfortable.
Yes. But when he's comfortable, when he is comfortable, I am comfortable. Mm. Because now he doesn't have to feel insecure, because he already knows his place. He already knows that he is good enough. So usually most people forget that men also have self-esteem issues.
I know. And there's so many by
exactly. The way. And even them themselves would not realize that they have those issues. So it's just, not all of them are, but there are quite a number that actually are fully confident in who they are. And the unfortunate bit, which is why people keep saying girls go for men with money. They know they're proud of themselves.
True.
You get it. It's not like they were born like that. They just learned, they reached a point in which they love themselves because they're secure, they know they have
money. They're loaded.
Exactly. Mm. The others, the problem is they feel like they have not reached a particular level, or you could easily leave me for this one. Or that's not the man you want to be with. Not the man that compares himself to other people.
Other men,
That's honestly true.
So I wonder if I think I'm going to have a depression. I'm not going to rehab.
No.
How did you manage?
Me going through it, to be honest, I threw myself the opposite direction. I went to church. I didn't realize that I was depressed. It took me, like I said, there's so many things someone can tell you. No touchy kitties.
Yes.
Like, you keep seeing this, you'll hear this, they'll tell you this, they'll tell you that, but you're refusing to deny it again.
Exactly. Yes.
And you're like, those things are for white people.
I hear white people.
I used to call it a white person's problem. Mm. Like, I didn't think here in Uganda you'll come and say, I'm depressed, and they'll slap it out of you.
What is that?
And you go, gamba depressed.
Yeah, you know.
But depression is actually real. It takes a while for you to realize it. And the thing that people think it's a disease, but it's actually a condition that you have. It's one of those things. It's like having asthma. You may feel okay, and you're not.
You're not.
You'll be able to walk around.
Yeah, exactly.
But you're actually not fine. You'll get back very home, sick. And then it hits you again.
True.
You'll be somewhere, and it will hit you. Mm-hmm. I used to have moments where I would actually be out with so many people, like events like Blankets and Wine. Everyone is all jolly, and when I'm gone, when I'm setting off from home, I'm happy and excited to go there, and then just watching other people be happy would take you back into that moment. Then I would
leave. You're like, I wish I didn't leave.
Then I would leave, and I didn't notice that trend just would keep happening slowly by slowly, and then I'm like, but what's wrong? Like, why am I not feeling fine? You're not feeling genuinely happy. You feel like the smiles that you give are when people are around you. And
but
when you're
they are
in
gone?
The comfort of your home, you're not happy.
You're crying,
exactly.
You're depressed.
You're crying, you're watching. I would have to look for particular type of movies because I could not watch others. And it's something, it takes you a while also to realize. It's not like an easy thing. I used church, and it's just by chance. I was trying to rediscover myself religiously. It all just happened basically at the same time. As I was trying to, learn, because I felt I'd reached a point in which I wanted more out of religion, not just we go to church on Sunday.
Yeah, just
and
to
then
pray.
We know that this guy, Jesus died on the cross.
Yeah, you know.
Then you see, they're like, those guys were cool, looking
so
nice.
Holy. Yeah,
exactly.
I know what you dress.
That kind of, exactly.
Yes.
So that was honestly where I was at. Not like it's a bad thing, because everyone has to find a channel in which they get to where they're going.
Yeah.
So my initial version of church would be, I was praying from KPC, and you kind of know everything is youthful and fun. I felt like that's what I was doing in church, and I wanted a more mature or growth when it came to religion by then. Just by chance, I happened to fix one problem with the other.
I know, right?
So it's I threw myself into church. I actually took a sabbatical off anything media related for like a year. You know what I mean? Like literally any. Yeah, it was a year. It had made a year. And I wasn't working or the funniest thing is I wasn't doing anything.
You were home.
I was home. Wow. I wasn't working. I would stay home. I would basically just
watch movies, listen to music.
Get up. I would go to church because this time, since I wasn't working, I could go to church at any time.
Mm.
So I'd go to church during day, come back on Wednesdays. I'd go to church at night.
No friends.
By then, I didn't have. Like people,
I get it.
There's even that thing in you that you feel like you can't exactly trust. You've lost that bit of.
True.
I'm going to tell this and my problems. You go and do
and
this. Usually, that's the biggest problem when it comes to depression. We fail to tell other people because we feel they're not going to help us or stand by us. They're basically just going to talk about
it.
So I kind of put myself into a shadow, and then I just now slowly, I realized, okay, I made friends at church, and. The friends were grown-ups.
Mm.
I wasn't relating now with people my age. And they were seeing life in a whole
different
way.
They have kids.
They have children.
Yeah,
they have this. And then you'd sit there and you're like, huh. And then they started inviting me to small little gatherings, like dinners and stuff. And I would basically be the youngest one. I would sit there and I would listen.
Bambi.
I'm like,
As if sitting with your parents.
Yes. And then there's some people who have problems, like genuine problems. They're like, what was I saying?
I know.
Like,
so that also helped you.
Yes, it also helped me because we would share and then people would come up with, it's not just sharing, just we would share, you pray for each other, and then whoever can be able to help one, the other could be able to help.
Mm.
And it actually helped me, like being around them changed me a lot. Because these were the grown-up people. I got up close and personal with Pastor Chiwewesi and Pastor David of Kansanga Miracle.
I know him.
And they would treat you like you're their own child.
Yes.
You wouldn't feel scared. Mm. You'd have a problem, but you wouldn't feel scared.
Mm.
Even if you want to cry, even if you want to,
yes, you'd
let it out. So I got the chance to let it out.
Oh dear.
To let it out and learn how to not just forgive whoever offended me, but also myself.
Yourself.
Because you're harboring anger, you're harboring feelings of resentment. Mm. You want to revenge, usually, honestly
bitterness,
speaking.
I know.
I mean, I felt like, if I see his kind, judge,
revenge.
That feeling. And all those feelings, when we harbor them, it actually drains us. It makes our hearts heavier. Mm. And that was the thing I needed to let go of. I didn't want to be bitter anymore. I just wanted to be free. Like free of that negative kind of emotion, so that I could see other things with positivity. Because I used to be a very positive person. Most people actually used to call me naive, and then all of a sudden I'd become a pessimist of everything.
Mm-hmm.
Even if someone was to give you a compliment, you'd think they're lying. Yet it's genuine.
True. I know
exactly.
It's true.
So it's all that I needed to win myself off of, and I had the chance. I gave myself time, and I didn't even notice that I was getting myself out of the depression. It just slowly happened, because I would now find more humble recreational activities, my TikTok. I would play around on TikTok half
your
the time.
I'm your follower, by the way, TikTok. Yes.
And it was a humble way. I would have fun. I would still feel in touch with the world without any pressure on me or anything. And you're just in free space. I'm minding my business. And just slowly by slowly, just things kept falling in place. After the TikTok thing, then an NTV finds me. Then all of a sudden I jump into dance party. I get a radio job.
Ochukuba.
Everything just kept happening. On social media, even before I already had filters on my socials, so it didn't really change as much. I've always not really been one for just generalized kind of comments. Somehow, if I don't really know you. I don't really let what you have to think affect me much. Otherwise, I would run mad. Because there are people who don't like you and there are people who do. So you can't really know who is who. Just first keep them all at a distance.
Mm.
And that actually worked for me. It helped me because I don't feel the pinch as much. It's not like, now it's different though.
Yeah, true.
Because at first I could be able to just do what I'm doing and no one cared about who she is. That girl is just jumping around. But now,
right now,
see, well, Lynda Ddane,
yeah, then
splash.
Yeah, yo, yo.
So it's like,
but I think it's a good thing.
The feeling is just, I'm getting used to it, but it's also real. I love the feeling.
So you mean he doesn't call? I think I love you up there.
He would.
Mm-hmm.
But
are you friends?
Yes.
You talk?
Yeah.
So Tagamba, GMS.
That one I wouldn't have a problem with, because like I said, I already had filters. I even when it comes to work, I have my work number and the one that I use for personal contacts, which are very few, which is awkward. It just so happened there are quite a few people that have particular people get to get my other number, my other side, like actual up close and personal.
Mm.
And then there's a number in which I can use to, because there's so many people who need chances, which I also check as well.
True.
There are people who can maybe forward you songs or need this or need that. So that one I also check, but I do not give it as much of my time as I would give my personal.
So now, are you ready to date again?
Yes. I want to get married. That sounds wrong, yeah? I'm not looking for dating, I'm looking for marriage.
Marriage.
So that's the difference.
But you have to date first, then?
Well, yes, but if you give someone the idea that you're looking for dating, I'm not looking to date
you
anyone.
You want a real marriage.
I want marriage.
Like
if
this.
That, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, but God. I will my husband, people. Jesus Christ, he will suffer. Hi.
Hey.
So my husband.
Thank you so much, Lynda. Banange, Lynda Ddane, awo dwagala okumanya yokwatako. So your dance party queen. Ku Saturday ya jiwamba yeba yeye. So sasa umulete, kari mbitegede. So nawe obere yo. Ngachayisemu badochisemu. Don't give up. Olaba alibwati, atenga achagena maso. Binji bichaja. So don't give up on yourself. Tosala okweta, tosala okwejambula mbwense woko depressed, oli depressed, no nyamata so okuyambako. Ate, mchujakutamula bulungi.
Yeah.
So mbele bulungi.
Bye-bye.